Let's talk Bitcoin and South Africa and the story over a cup of coffee. If you look at the 5th of May, exactly a year ago, right? The rand dollar 14.34, today 19.33. So that is exactly a year. If you look at the chart of Bitcoin, so a year ago, you could buy Bitcoin for 5831.17, and this morning the price was 8897.47. Now, let's start putting this all together, and perhaps let me take you to an Excel spreadsheet. This is the summary of this spreadsheet. So, on the 5th of the 5th, 2019, the price of a Bitcoin was 5831. The exchange rand versus dollars 14.39. That means if you've taken, let's say, $1 million out of your bond and you parked it there. Now, I'm not saying at all that you should ever do anything like this. It's just a hypothetical scenario to illustrate the point. Okay, please make sure that you get this. I've got a course on altcoins and stuff where I'm explaining the risk and how dangerous it can be and the whole story. So if you like more information on that, just give me a comment. I'll give you the link and then you can get a better overview and a better understanding of how it works. So make sure that you know anything before you invest in anything. Right? So if you had $1 million rand at that point, that would give you at that exchange rate simply $69,691. If you exchange that in order to buy bitcoins, you would get for the full amount 11.95 bitcoins. Now, a year later, today, exactly a year later, let's say you want to cash in, and remember, this is just hypothetical based on actual figures, right? So, in today's value, if you're going to do this and you've got $1 million and you exchange it at 19.335, it simply means that you'd only get $51,719. This basically means there's a loss of $17,900, which is the equivalent of, let's call it a growth. If you had to invest the $51,719, you had to get 34.75% growth in order to get back to the $69,691. Okay, this can also be the inflation if you look at another way. So the inflation rate over the last year in South Africa compared to dollars, Bitcoin is 34.75%. But there's another way to look at it. In other words, if you've got 11 Bitcoins today and you cash that in, that is going to give you 11.95 times the 8897. That is what the Bitcoin was worth this morning. That gives you 106. Now, if you take the 106 back to rand or the dollars back to rand, that simply means it's 106,338 times 19.335, and that gives you 2 million. So this is the end result. So if you've taken a million, of course there would be interest and stuff like that you had to pay, but that money would be worth 2,056,048 rands and 50 cents today, which means it's a growth of 106. So I hope that you see when it comes to a leverage on leverage, what can happen with your money. But we're not done. So let me show you something else because I think this is also interesting. And let's get back to what happened in South Africa on the 23rd of March. Cyril Ramaphosa said, okay, we're in this lockdown, or that's the date that I've got. So if we look from there, we see that at that stage, you could buy a Bitcoin for 4023.97 US dollars, and today you'll have to pay 8897.47. So if you do exactly the same calculation, and let's get back to Excel, and you do exactly the same calculation, you'll find that you'll even in a shorter period would be far better off. And this is in a time when the stock market and the house market and everything basically came to, I can't say to stand still, it's not 100% truth, but you know the results. So over this very, very short time period, your money would be worth from 1 million to 2.9 million. That gives us an 198% growth. So that was the little story that I